Have a 2000 Deluxe brought to you with the help of Export Gold.
Ah, 2000, you beauty!
That's a base kick.
Look, taste it. You can feel it roll around in it, New Zealand, it's yours. Look at that, a brand new millennium. It's a new century.
It's a new millennium, it's the year 2000. People are still smiling, people are still happy, the kids are still laughing, the cars are still driving, things are still going.
And you run your naked foot through grass and you go, I had a wonderful Christmas and a wonderful New Year's. What did you do?
Of course I had a wonderful New Year's and a wonderful Christmas and vowed on New Year's Eve to keep smiling into this new millennium.
Let's make it a smiling year. Look, see, it's good, eh? On our first show of the year 2000, Havoc 2000 Deluxe, it was very, a lot of forward thinking with us there, wasn't there, eh? Eh? On the first show of the year 2000, Robin Williams.
Maybe the funniest man in the world.
English DJs.
Maybe the best DJs in the world.
And you and me and everything else that's wonderful. You know the big difference between what we did on New Year's Eve, the turning of 1999 to the year 2000, was that other television presenters seemed to be a lot of places they didn't want to be, with people they didn't want to be with, having no fun at all. But we had heaps of fun.
They moaned about it too, didn't
they? They even moaned.
They were moaning about it. By the time it was 12 o'clock, they were moaning. They were moaning. Liz Gunn moaning. It was cold. Moaning. Just don't do it.
But we had a load of fun. How about you? Hey? Maybe you were one of the people that was stuck in an 8-hour traffic jam climbing Takaka Hill together at the gathering. Those people going up the side of DJs, DJ privilege. We were limited for time, of course, so we had to take a helicopter in. And fair enough, too. We're on the telly.
As the clouds gathered over the unsuspecting gatherers waiting to gather, there was no sign of the skinheads with AK-47s. Excitement was in the air. It's like country calendar on acid.
This dusty road was to be the last dry thing that the gatherers saw as the mud prevailed over this exciting millennium event. An event where you're allowed to be free, express yourself. Show your inner child. Go, man. Yeah. If you're this man, send us a self-addressed envelope and some proof of identification, and we'll send you a 3-month subscription to TV Guide and Turf Digest. But the thing is about the gathering, it's about fun and funky fresh music for all ages. Look at this happy older couple enjoying themselves at the hoedown tent. Room to swing a cat and to have a bit of a laugh. Look at this poor twat. Here we go. Ah! Oh, the poor old geezer. Look at him. Oh, oh, down he goes again. Oh, oh, oh! What are you going to have a shower? Oh, that's right, there's no shower. Oh, no, that's right. No one saw you, mate. Don't worry about it. Yeah, no, you're sweet. Yeah, just party on, bro. Still, it delivered the goods. Pulled it out of the bag again, that dirty old gathering, eh? 8 thou. There were 8 thou.
15 thou.
Was it?
27 thou.
Not you. That may be absolute nonsense figures. But the good thing is, in New Zealand, the three biggest dance events in the whole country on New Year's Eve, a handful of arrests. Now that's good, isn't it? Wonder why that is.
Well, mainly it's because of the sophisticated cafe culture and the lowering of the drinking age to 18 and the responsibility that youth now have.
There was a lot of them and they were very well behaved, and therefore the rumours that there's not going to be another gathering are false. There most probably will be. Things are going off at the crash tent. Sorted, mate.
frock. Poor old Jay, our cameraman, eh? Look at those new shoes his mum saved up for Christmas. They're ruined. Ooh. Oh, no, now he's lost his hay fever tablets. Or has he? It's like Disneyland, isn't it? Muddy old Disneyland. But with drum and bass guys.
Steady. Easy. Easy red.
But while the gatherers were ploughing up the fields of Takaka Hill, what was the rest of New Zealand doing on their holidays?
It's Donald from the phone logs. On the summer break, went to Mother's at Christmas, waited for Santa. New Year, spent it at the viaduct with 100,000 others screaming, shut up millennium. But best of all, I had a...
Still to come on New Zealand's favourite half hour of television.
Could you see yourself as a cycle courier? Maybe in the old days, if cycle couriers were around.
Oh, yes, sir.
Scratching for a bit of money.
Yes, sir.
Trying to knock it all together.
Yes, sir, very much so. You know, driving all day, 24 hours a day, just, you know, making a little cash, you know what I mean? Just for snacks, you know, and eventually they find your tax form and say, excuse me, there's $25,000 for snacks, yeah, on Columbian College Fund. Yeah, I could have done that, but let's see, how to survive an avalanche.
What a great time over the holiday break we had reading your emails, faxes and letters and conversing with you as well.
And what a great time over the holiday break we had driving our Ferrari, thank you.
Thank you very much. Before we move on, because there's only two shows left, there's the next show and then the final show of the series, which will be the Big Day Out special, because that's not very far away at all. Two things I want to get in. Firstly, the... which is used in this respect, perhaps in the workplace or at school, once school starts again. Example.
Come on down to Victoria Park Market, bring your whole family. It's wicked.
Or, of course, there's the classic, which is done this way. Perhaps news you can be a school teacher making some very pathetic, witty remark as you turn round to the board again.
Sure. Amo, amas, amat, amamus, amatus, amabant.
Classic. You can use them at your own, thank you. You can use them at your whimsy, courtesy of us. Just, that's a little present from us, eh? It's a New Year's present.
Yeah, you're allowed to.
Now, of course, make sure that you're watching the show next week, because we're going to ask you a simple question. If you ring, and then you ring 0900 Havoc, and you could win a double pass to the Big Day Out, which gets you on stage with the Chili Peppers and into the private guest bar. And that's what I'm doing this.
That's right, Mikey. But viewers, if you live outside of Auckland, City of Sails, the Queen City, the city in the bay, the city that rocks, the city that never stops, you'll be flown here courtesy of Air New Zealand, staying at the City Life Hotel with transfers by Gold Eagle Limousines. If you live in Auckland, however, you won't. You can drive yourself and stay at your own house that night.
Don't forget, news, the winner needs to attend the Big Day Out or to be able to travel to the Big Day Out by January the 21st. That's the Friday.
Plus, there's 10 consolation Big Day Out prize packs with a ticket and a copy of the Big Day Out CD and some export gold merchandise and whatnot.
Be watching next week for the number and the question. Cue the picture of the lifeguard at Piha Beach. This is where we went to interview some of the fellows that were over here for the Cream dance party on New Year's Eve.
Oh, Siobhan.
Now, these young gentlemen were here to play records, and good ones. So we sat on the beach and had a wee chat. But now the whole world loves house music. Why would house DJs come here? Hi, Dick.
Hello, how are you?
Dick Johnson. Dick Johnson from?
From Blackpool, northwest of England.
What do you do, Dick? What do you do with yourself?
I do lots of things for myself, but I DJ and produce tracks, and we run a record label called Shaboom Records.
Oh, and who are you?
And I'm Peter, I'm from Manchester, and I'm from Paper Recordings, and I'm just here to see what happens in New Zealand. It's a month away.
Ben?
Yeah, I'm here to also to munt, get munted. I'm from Paper Recordings and Shaboom Records, along with Dickie Dollars and the Juggernaut.
And you, sir?
Miles from Manchester also, Paper Recordings, here to DJ and make records when I'm back home.
Put the needle on the record, boys, and they did! At Cream, a Lightspeed event, 4,000 people, one arrest. You know, these record labels that they run do very well down here, surprisingly. You might not know who they are, but a lot of people do. Does it surprise you that New Zealanders love your music so much?
I don't understand it myself. But it's good.
How would you, for people who don't know the type of music that you make, how would you describe it?
House music, just deep, funky, you know, all sorts, sort of, you know, soulful vocals, you know, a lot of techie stuff as well.
Have you ever had any songs in the top 20?
We're working on it, but not yet, no. Give us a call this time next year, and we might be there.
Where do you hope to be this time next year, apart from here?
Well, here.
Yeah. We're here again.
We're still here. Yeah. Why did you choose? Why did you choose here for your holidays, apart from the fact it's summer? Well, I mean, you could have gone to Australia or Bali, India or Jakarta.
People, really?
A calm spot on a surf beach. It's a rip. Don't swim there. Ever.
What's a bunch of arse about the dance scene in England at the moment?
Just jewels.
Trance is just like, it's spreading like a viral infection.
Yeah. It'll be here next year, you watch it coming.
Yeah, it's, yeah. Tighten up your seatbelts, because it's on the way without a doubt.
I don't want to be caught by this trance, as you call it. What can I do to avoid it?
Keep your head down.
The New Zealand Lifeguard Service is voluntary. They work bloody hard and get paid fuck all. And these four pasty Englishmen acknowledge that by donating all the profits from Cream 2000. Any final words?
No, just that we're happy to be here and thanks for all the support, really. You know, the gigs have been brilliant.
We're going to try and spread the philosophy of munting when we get home.
Yeah.
So if we go to England in 5 years' time, everyone will be getting munted.
Yeah.
That's a bloody nice life, isn't it, eh? Go and do a big gig on New Year's Eve, loads of people, sit around in the sun on a summer's day, New Zealand beach. Who could ask for anything more? Or maybe Robin Williams?
How to survive an earthquake. If you're indoors, stay there. Yeah, wise choice. Yeah, where are you?
Some people don't know these things.
If you're driving, stop, but carefully. If you're in a mountainous area, watch out for falling rocks, landslide, trees, and other debris that could be loosened by quakes. If you're outside, get into the open, away from buildings, power lines, chimneys, and anything else that might fall on you. Wise choice.
This, which is, some people don't know that, Robin.
Yeah. If you're in a building near Roseanne Barr, get under her. I'm sorry, it's just for a last moment of fun.
Here at Havoc 2000 Deluxe, we love to gloat. And boy, did we gloat when we got the Robin Williams interview.
What is it, Daddy?
Of course, they meant we had to talk about Bicentennial Man, his new movie, where he's a robot.
Wow.
Hey, a robot.
Two cannibals were eating a clown. One turns to the other and says, "Does this taste funny to you? How do you make a hanky dance? Put a little boogie in it."
Show a few bits from the movie.
What exactly is it doing?
He shows a number of characteristics like creativity,
but don't give too much away.
Friendship.
Good night, sweetheart.
Good night, Andrew.
It is a household appliance, and yet you act like it is a man.
You're unique.
To lure you into the interview.
I feel responsibility to help you.
To fulfill your public relations duties.
External physical upgrade only. The secret to all this is imperfect.
In the movie, Robin becomes a real man.
Look what I'm doing here. I am trying to make something.
It made Petra Baghurst cry.
Does she notice?
Could we talk about this another time?
Quite a lot.
He's a bunch of nerves.
Hey, look, I'm sitting next to Robin Williams on the couch, and I'm incredibly honoured. You're taking out time on the second to last day before Christmas.
Yes, sir.
To talk to myself, Mike Havoc. I'm Mike. Hi,
nice to meet you.
And over there waiting for a fax at the business centre
is Newsboy.
Is the Newsboy.
The Newsboy.
Morning.
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 Whilst Robin Williams is a very famous actor, my family comes first, and it was Christmas, and I had important matters to attend to. Dear Miss Crosby, I've thought about our meeting about top of the morning.
We bought a few presents for you and the
bless
family.
You. Bless you,
I know you don't drink, but it's always right to get a bottle of wine. That's the Havoc Newsboy wine.
Havoc. Oh, good week.
Thank you. That's a good episode.
Yeah, thanks for this.
This is a good book for the whole family, written by a New Zealander.
Underwater
illustrated by
Melon Man.
Unreasonable rhymes.
Oh, really? This doesn't have anything.
I think
about
it might tickle your fancy.
Really? There's nothing here about masturbates and semen stains? There's nothing in there?
That one's quite good. Read that one out.
Okay. Mr. Wally Watermelon and Miss Ollie Cauliflower took shelter in the tool shed from a sudden summer shower. They tasted love's sweet blessings neath a barrow dry and shady and scandalized the garden with a melancholy baby. We'll be right back. How much money have we raised?
There we go. There we go.
Daddy, what does that mean?
Vegetable sex. It's not the size of the cucumber.
Let's sit and talk. Let's talk about what I was going to do. Let's sit and talk. I'm hugging Robin Williams. I've wanted to do that for years.
What about your nipples? Don't admit that.
Well, I don't know. We're back. Let's sit and talk.
I was 15 years old and drunk and running through a holiday resort going, follow the Ho Chi Minh Trail. Follow the Ho Chi Minh Trail.
Jesus, from watching Good Morning Vietnam.
Yeah. I just thought about that last night and I thought, oh, that was Robin Williams as well. Oh,
yes, that was me.
And that was you and Baron Munchausen. That's one of the favourite bits you did.
Serious?
Yeah.
It's a great movie.
It's a good, eh? It's a good movie, Baron Munchausen.
Yeah, strange movie. Yeah. Strange, wild movie.
Good Gilliam, to be in, though.
Yeah, working with Terry Gilliam is like, you know, a day at Club Medicated. He's like, he can do wilder stuff, like in The Fisher King, where we were shooting. I'm running down Columbus Avenue in New York, running from a flaming night. This night is... Around the corner, there's a wino who goes, that's some pretty good work, my friend. I see that every damn day. Way to go.
Yeah.
And yeah, and you shoot in New York with him, it was wild.
Cool. And you got, and then you move on, you've done all sorts of stuff. You did stand up last night.
Yeah, it was wild. It was.
You did stand up at Planet Hollywood last night.
Yeah, one of the last surviving Planet Hollywoods, ladies and gentlemen. Check into Stallone.com or .com. Remember that. It was like, it was strange because all of a sudden they said, come up, and I started, you know, started playing off of the place because it's got all this stuff hanging from the walls. And you start talking about old movies.
I believe they tried to get you to put your hands in the cement and you wouldn't do it.
No, I don't want to do that. No, it's like stealing your soul.
It is. It steals your soul.
Yeah, be careful. White man, no come. Kevin Costner, no call.
Now you've got your new movie out there, which is what you're here for. Are you here for to just do that, or are you actually here to visit our fair country, Robert?
Your fair country, Michael.
It's a double-edged sword.
It is.
Oh, wow.
We've used a large word today.
Sword. It's a gale of sword will be the Simmons. And welcome to impediment.com, please.
Here for this is the last one today. We have a little bit more press, and then I'm done, and I can travel for 11 days around New Zealand.
Wow.
Yeah, it'd be good.
Dear Television New Zealand, I'm concerned that I wasn't asked to anchor the TV2's slick, informative, stylish news breaks. While Stacey Daniels is a nice woman, she...
So the movie, the Bicentennial Man movie with Elvira and Sam Neill, a charming gentleman, isn't it? Dry.
Dry. A bit dry. Dry. Right? Drier than a wombat's ass, my friend. Very dry. But basically, knows a good joke when he sees it.
Yeah, and he knows it by going like this. Raises that eye.
Yeah, ooh. Ooh.
Yeah, watch
right
Sam.
There, watch.
I've been watching Sam, I've been watching
not
you.
Not dormant, my friend. He's not dormant.
He's not dormant.
No, he had a good time. We started to play and riff a little bit, which was good.
Now, you could look at the movie on a couple of levels. You could look at it as a feel-gooder.
Right.
You could look at it as a vehicle for you.
Okay.
Or there's something a bit more to it than that, isn't there, when you sit back, like, straight after it, couldn't tell you what I thought. A couple of hours, I thought, oh, I get where it's all coming from.
Ah, the old half-life, eh?
Yeah, the old have-o half-life.
Yeah, then we actually go, oh, my God, I provoked a thought there.
Yeah.
The idea of artificial intelligence and what it is to be human, possibly. That's what we want to try and do. And if you had that thought an hour later, not bad.
See, straight off the cover, I wouldn't have thought that Robin Williams would have taken that part.
Who would you think would be better? If we can pick other people, let me see. You can have Eddie Murphy as a robot. That'd be cool. Right there. I'm not doing no Windows 99. Give that shit up. But I think I took it because I thought I wanted to be inside that suit working to see what humanity I could find right off the bat.
So I was surprised how much of the movie that you couldn't do much.
Yeah, because you're bound by the laws of the mechanics of the suit. But then you start to, you know, you change and become an android and then kind of a bio-droid and then eventually human.
As you do,
well, if you're lucky.
That sort of story obviously turns you on mentally.
Mentally, yeah.
Yeah.
You like being hard all over, Robin?
The prosthetic suit that made Robin Andrew the android cost $70 million to make and had to be scrubbed with a mixture of toothpaste and charcoal to get rid of lice and fungi at the end of every shoot. Not comfortable, but they let him keep the watch.
Now, what about you? What's inside Robin Williams that we don't already know about?
I'm sorry. It's back there.
There's a lot of before Christmas. There was a lot to do.
Still getting a lot of facts.
Yeah,
last minute,
I mean,
Christmas.
What about you that we don't know? I mean, do you like mountain biking? We've discovered that's a new thing.
I like road biking, mountain biking. I think some people know. Computer's broken. I'm getting a fax too.
Well,
hold on.
Here we go.
Wait. What do you know about other things you don't know? God, I don't know. Let's see.
I thought
furry thing everyone knows. It's pretty easy to see.
I was going
to
ask you because look at them loaded.
Jesus, my hell! Don't do this because I actually saw. Have you seen the videotapes that they had videotapes for Coco the gorilla and she's. Was picking out a mate, and my son, I said, you should send a tape in of yourself. Why? So Coco will go,
Cook.
Your son sit there.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's rough. Got to
he's
hurt,
16.
It? 16. Yeah, biting.
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 Biting wit of the little bastard.
Now, one of my favourite things that you ever did was on Live at the Met.
Ah.
You see, I love Live at the Met.
Ah, yes.
Live at the Met, the two things I discovered about you. One that I believe, I reckon that the thing that sets you apart from... Just leave him alone.
No, just behind me.
The thing that sets you apart from everybody else is it looks like you try to make yourself laugh first.
Yeah.
And that's more important than anything else?
Yeah.
Hello, Adam.
No, it's just a hello, it's okay. He's working.
And do you think that's true?
I just realised I've been had. That's all right, I've just noticed, okay. I just realised I've been pissed on. It's all right. I didn't know that before, but I know it's the old Texas switch. I know you bait me, he's behind me. I got it.
No,
none of that. No, you know that. Remember that, don't you, Earl?
No.
I'm not going to pull faces behind your back. I'm not Mark Wright, the undisputed king of New Zealand comedy. Especially not when across from me is this man, Big Green. Oh. Time to pull out the emergency dolphin question.
Hey, Mikey, ask Mr. Williams about the dolphins. About the dolphins. Yeah.
Yeah, the dolphins.
The dolphins.
Thank you, sir.
You swim with the dolphins well, haven't you, Mr. Williams?
Yeah, I swim.
Well, I can talk to the dolphins.
Have you done that? Oh, be careful. That's big time. All of a sudden, they start getting very like.
Yeah.
The spotted dolphins and the bottlenose.
Done the swimming with the dolphins?
Yeah,
I started off
with the bottlenose dolphins, and that was I got bitten by one because I.
Did you?
I pissed him off. I don't know what happened.
Before I run out of time, I've got two more questions. I've got one, Mork and Mindy.
Yeah.
Mork and Mindy.
All right, sir.
Mork and Mindy, how'd you do the drinking thing? Was it through the table?
No, sir, it was actually a thing where you popped that down and then a little thing fell out of the bottom and that was over.
We love Mork and Mindy. It made such a difference.
Thank you, sir. It's nice to know. It got me a ranch and I'm all right by that.
Impressions, very good at it. Aladdin, full of impressions.
Yes.
King of impressions. Anyone you can't do?
Ask him to do Paul Holmes.
People I can't do, I've had to. Tony Blair is just because he's... Yes.
Yeah.
The Tony Blair Witch Project. Thinking about other people.
Could you do our Mr. Holmes who interviewed you last night?
Mr. Holmes is very. This is something about Mr. Holmes is kind of frightening. Listen, I saw Mr. Holmes sweating like Elizabeth Taylor after a Mexican meal. It was like it was very frightening. You just had to. Oh, Roman, nice.
Is he like?
He was very, very sweet man. Very nice man. Are you happy or sad? At that point, I kind of went, oh, I don't know, really. Oh, God.
There is so much to ask you, really. You've got your kids here with you. Are you happy, man, or are you sad, man?
Happy, man.
Yeah.
Happy, man. This is very happy, man.
Are you happy, man, or are you sad, man? Are you happy, man, or are you sad, man? Are you happy, man, or are you sad, man?
Do you ever storm out?
No. Well, walked off? No, there's nothing been too rough where I've been.
Could you do a storm out for us?
I mean, piss off just because you blew your fucking fuses. Okay, give me this. I've seen you trying to get another video. Yeah, right there, Mike. Work with me now, huh? There you are, Mikey. Oh, look at this. Wait. Give me $59,000 more dollars, we'll have a movie. Right there it is.
Oh, fuck God, no! Too late! Run, you bastard! Jesus, don't you understand? Don't you understand? It's not right. You shouldn't be promoting a movie like this.
What does it say at the end of the interview? Unplug the camera.
That's it. Bastard.
Turn it
off. Well, what a nice chap that Mr. Robin Williams was.
Gag. From the start to the end, it was just gags.
Very funny. Honoured to be in his presence, honestly. Hey, won't you join us next week for our second to last show of this series of Havoc 2000 Deluxe? And because the last one's going to be the Big Day Out special, which you could win the tickets and all that sort of stuff, like we said before, the next show, of course, is going to have a lot jammed into it, isn't it?
Thank you very much, New Zealand, for having us back into your homes.
It's nice to be on the television in the year 2000. So with the classics and the... See you next week.
No, no.
Night.